Do you know what I may do?
No, dear.
I may take up woodwork.
What brought that on?
What brought what on?
You're lying there, reading a book called The Greatest Disasters of the 20th Century. And you're thinking of taking up woodwork?
Actually, I was reading about the Titanic and it set a train of thought going.
The Titanic?
Yeah, the liner that hit the iceberg in 1912.
Oh, yes, I know.
You see, there weren't enough lifeboats for everybody to get away, and that meant that only the women and children could be rescued.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. Do you know what I would have done if I'd been on board?
Drowned?
No, June, I would have not have drowned.
Dressed up as a woman and got into a lifeboat?
No. That's charming, isn't it? What a dreadful thing to say about your husband.
I'm sorry.
I wouldn't have... What makes you think I would stoop so low as to pretend to be a woman?
Well, you could hardly pretend to be a child.
I would not have pretended to be anybody.
Well, they wouldn't have let you into the lifeboat and you're not much of a swimmer and yet you say you wouldn't have drowned.
Correct.
All right. What would you have done?
I would have made a raft.
You couldn't have.
Why not?
You wouldn't have had the time.
That, June, is where you are wrong. I have the facts in front of me. Do you want to hear them?
No, not really.
The Titanic hit an iceberg at 11:40, but she didn't sink until 2:20.
Well, I never.
And that is 2 hours and 40 minutes, which will have given me ample time to make a raft.
Well, I never.
June, are you listening to me?
Well, yes, of course. But if it was that easy, why didn't everybody make rafts?
A very good question, and the answer is here. In the magnificent ballroom, the passengers continue to dance while the mighty Levi Arthon...
Levi who?
Levi Arthon.
Who was he then?
Oh, June, there are such incredible gaps in your knowledge. It frightens me.
Just because I don't know the name of everyone aboard the Titanic, I wouldn't call that an incredible gap.
But it's another name for the ship. I mean, sometimes they call it the Titanic and sometimes they call it the mighty Levi Arthon.
Why?
Well, because Levi Arthon is another name for a very large ocean liner.
Well, how am I supposed to know that?
Well, do what I did, look it up in the dictionary.
I see.
So now you know why everybody didn't make rafts and get away.
Do I?
I've just told you.
You mean they were all looking up words in the dictionary?
No, they were in the ballroom dancing. They danced as the ship sank.
On the other hand, it's just possible they didn't have any wood.
Well, of course they did. I mean, what about the cabin doors? I mean, how many cabin doors do you need to make a raft? All you do is take two off and screw them together.
Where would you get the screws from?
Off the hinges that hold the door on.
And supposing you didn't have a screwdriver?
I would not have needed one.
Oh, come off it.
Right.
Now what are you doing?
I'm going to take this bedroom door off without using a screwdriver.
How?
I don't quite know how yet, but I'm going to show you that a determined person can overcome any catastrophe if they use their initiative.
Oh, Terry, for heaven's sake, come back to bed. It's 12:10.
Good. That gives me until 2:50 to make the raft.
Don't be such an idiot.
All right, you call me an idiot, but I mean, supposing you're... Imagine it's a freezing cold night in the North Atlantic and you're still in the lifeboat and I'm born. And you're on your knees praying, saying, oh, please, God, let Terry find some way to get that cabin door off its hinges and join me.
I wouldn't bank on it.
Sit up. Sit up and watch. Come on. Watch what I'm doing. I'm about to use a nail file and a small coin.
You know, if I wrote about this to a woman's magazine, they wouldn't believe me.
Just watch.
Dear Marge, my husband leapt out of bed at midnight and started taking the bedroom door off its hinges with a nail file.
I've got it started.
He did this to demonstrate how he would have escaped from the Titanic.
It's coming.
We live in Purley and not too many icebergs come our way. But I'm sure that if one did, the local council would deal with it.
Will you stop nattering while I'm trying to concentrate?
If he keeps this up, should I insist on separate bedrooms? You're sincerely worried of Pearlie.
June, I've got a screw loose.
You won't get an argument from me.
There we are. It's out. Now, how long did that take?
I don't know, and I really don't care. May I go to sleep now, please?
Only if you are satisfied.
What with?
That I could have got the door off the hinges and made a raft.
Oh, yes, completely.
Right, that is it, then. I'll put that back in the morning.
Why not now?
I've broken your nail, Fowl.
Thank you.
On the other hand, I could use your nail scissors.
I've got a much better idea.
What?
Borrow my hat and coat and come and sneak into the lifeboat.
No. All right. All right, perhaps we can now go to sleep. Good night.
Good night. Oh, no!
What's up? What's up?
Well, can't you hear it?
Hear what?
That idiot playing the drums again.
Well, pull the blankets over your head.
Oh, honestly, it is disgraceful.
Well, he's got to practice.
Well, why in the middle of the night?
Well, what better time when everybody's asleep? Then he won't annoy anybody.
Well, he's annoying me. I think I shall speak to the Residents' Association.
You speak to them if you like. I have resigned.
Oh, darling, I'm sorry. I'd forgotten. No. I'm sorry.
Can we have the light out?
Yes, I suppose so. Oh, dear. Now, what on earth's he playing?
Sounds like a kettle drum. Well, I don't know what that was.
I do. The bedroom door has just fallen off its hinges. What are you doing?
Oh, I thought it was the alarm clock.
It's the front doorbell.
Well, I know that now.
What time is it?
Do you really want to know?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, dear. It's 7:10.
On a Sunday morning? Well, who can that be? I hope it's not bad news.
Hello, Terry. I haven't got you out of bed, have I?
Good heavens, no. 7 o'clock on a Sunday morning, we've been up for hours. Don't bother coming down, June. It's our dear neighbour, Tarquin.
Actually, I only just popped in for a bit of a chat.
Oh, good, good. There's nothing I like more than a chat first thing in the morning. Gives you an appetite for breakfast.
Well, I've got a busy day ahead of me. You know, of course, that I've been appointed chairman of the Residents' Association.
So I've heard.
Yes, I'm sorry to hear that you've resigned from the committee.
Well, I mean, we won't need me now. Not now you're running everything.
Oh, I don't know about that. After all, you are a resident, and every little helps. We need you.
No, well, what position did you have in mind?
We want someone to fold the newsletters and push them through letterboxes.
That is a job any idiot could do.
Exactly.
Sorry.
So, I brought them with me.
I'm sorry, I shan't have time to do that, sorry.
Oh, dear, that is a pity. Oh, well, there were one or two other things I wanted to talk to you about. Did you hear somebody playing the drums last night?
As a matter of fact, I did.
I'm trying to find out who it was.
Why, what are you doing, getting up a dance band?
No, I am forming a noise abatement group.
Ooh, they should be a load of fun to dance to. What do they do, play in mime?
It's a waste of time talking to you, Terry, when you're in this kind of mood. I shall appeal to June. She's the only one in this house with any sense of civic responsibility.
Oh, that's good, that is. I was a founder member, of the Residents' Association, and everything was going fine till you moved in and started taking over.
I think you're being rather childish, Terry. We could do with a little fresh blood around here.
You keep waking people up at 7 o'clock on a Sunday morning, mate, you'll see more blood than you bargained for.
All right, I'm good. Oh, by the way, do you know anything about that dreadful-looking van parked outside the house?
Van? What sort of van?
Oh, it's a terrible-looking thing, all falling to pieces.
Good Lord, no. Why ask me?
Because it's got your name painted on it.
What?
There you are. Medford's Worldwide Removal Service.
Well, that's not me.
No, it's me. Hello, Uncle.
You've met my nephew, Alan, I take it.
Oh, yes. Indeed, I have.
I didn't think you were up yet. Because it's Sunday, I didn't want to disturb you.
How considerate of you.
Well, I've just got a bit of work to do on the van, then I'll pop in for breakfast.
So he's travelling worldwide, is he?
Oh, I do hope so.
I hope you weren't rude to him.
I never said a word. He's still out there crawling underneath his van.
I didn't mean Alan. I meant Tarquin.
Oh, him.
Look. Terry, I'm sure if the committee had known you wanted to be chairman...
June, I haven't got time now in future for that rubbish. I told you last night I'm taking up woodwork.
What sort? Door repairs?
Any sort. I mean, for years I've sacrificed myself for the good of this community. I devoted all my spare time to running things and helping things along. Well, from now on, he can do it. In future, I shall devote my mind to developing the skill of hand, eye, brain and coordination.
Terry, be careful!
Sorry. I think I should buy a lathe with a circular saw attachment.
Oh, I wouldn't do that.
Well, I mean, you could make anything with one of those. I mean, look at the money we'd save. I could make everything we needed.
Apart from a new milk jug, all we really need is a new washing machine.
June, I can't make a washing machine out of wood.
No, but if you can afford one of those woodworking things, why can't we have a new washing machine?
Well, for a start, that won't save us any money, having a new washing machine.
Yes, it will. The man has to come every fortnight to mend it.
I'll look at it.
No, I'd rather you didn't. You had one look at it, and that's why the man has to come every fortnight to mend it.
I mean, I don't know why you don't want me to take up woodwork. I mean, I'm going to be careful. Oh, sorry.
It's just that I don't like the idea of you playing around with those whizzing circular saws.
But, I mean, for modern woodwork, I mean, you need one.
I can't see why. If you could have saved all those people on board the Titanic with a nail file, why do you need a circular saw?
I shall not argue. I shall go upstairs and have a bath and a shave.
What about Alan?
I think he's old enough to bath himself.
What's he doing out there with that van?
I've no idea. Fry a piece of bacon and fan the fumes outside and he'll be in like a shop. You can ask him.
Hi, Auntie June. Oh, is that bacon frying?
Yes, dear. Alan. Huh? What on earth are you doing with that van?
I've gone in for antiques.
Yes, I can see that, dear. But what are you doing with it?
Not the van. I'm dealing in antiques. I'm exporting them all over the world.
Oh, fancy that.
Yes. Oh, before I have my breakfast, could I just make a quick phone call?
Yes, I suppose so.
Thanks, Auntie. Oh.
Alan, where on earth are you dialing?
Frankfurt. Hello, is that Helmut? Oh, guten Morgen, ist das Helmut? Alan, ja. Ja. I haven't the foggiest idea what he's talking about. You don't speak German, do you?
Only a little bit we did at school.
Fine. Hang on, Helmut, bitte. Here comes mine Auntie June, bitte. What can sprechen Deutsche better, bitte?
Hallo? Ja, ich bin die Tante von Alan, Frau Medford.
Oh, that's great, Auntie, great. Now, just ask him if the roll-top desk got out there all right. Say we couldn't send him the sofa because it had woodworm and the leg fell off it. And we couldn't put the piano on because we haven't got the sort he wanted, but we're still looking. Oh, and would he like a Davenport?
In a moment, bitte. Alan, I'm not that fluent.
Yes, you are. You're great. Look, say we've got the next load nearly ready. 6 Edwardian china cabinets, 4 Canterburys...
Alan, and please, will you listen?
What's up?
I haven't started yet. I don't know the German for roll-top desk.
Ah. I can help you there. I know what the German for roll is. It's Brötchen.
Is it?
Yeah, because a ham roll is Brötchen mit Schinken. And a cheese roll is Brötchen mit Käse. Oh, they make some lovely grub out there. Makes me hungry just thinking about it. In fact, while you're chatting, Auntie, I'll just go and make myself a quick bacon sarnie.
Oh, hallo, ja? Herr Helmut, meine Deutsche ist Schülerdeutsche. Ja. Oh, eine... Ein term only. Then it was the needlework, yeah. ich must to the kitchen gehen. Mein Nephew Alan ist stuffing himself mit bacon sandwiches. Au revoir, auf Wiedersehen, pardon.
Of course, it's getting harder to find good stuff. I don't suppose you've got any furniture you want to get rid of, have you?
I don't think so, dear. Have we, Terry?
Well, there's all that stuff in the garage. We'll have to clear some of that out.
Will we?
Well, of course. I mean, that's where I'm going to put my workshop.
What workshop's this, then?
Your uncle is taking up woodwork. He's developing the skills of the hand and the eye.
Oh, dear. There's a piece of this jug missing.
Look on your elbow, darling.
Yeah? Oh, it's instant glue, you know. You've got to watch it every second.
But you've squeezed far too much of it out. You're only supposed to use a tiny drop.
I don't suppose you see any second-hand woodworking machinery, do you?
Now, isn't that funny? I was offered some only last week. A lathe with a circular saw attachment. Bit knocked about.
Oh, marvellous. Where was it?
Croydon. Oh, wait, what was the address?
Joan, get a pencil and take this down, will you?
I've got it. I remember. It made me mouthwater. Sandwich Drive. 108 Sandwich Drive. Do you want me to pick it up for you?
No, I want to see it first. Are you coming with me, June?
What, now?
No, why not? See you later, Alan.
See you.
Well, I expect I'll still be here. Auntie!
This is it.
Yes? Hello. I understand you have a circular saw for sale.
Oh, yes, that's right. If you'd like to come this way, it's round the back. Here we are, then. Goes like a bomb. I'll find a bit of wood and you can try it out.
Fine.
Terry, ask him what he's done to his hand.
Good Nick.
That's more than he is. Ask him what he's done to his hand.
It is none of our business.
Oh, it is. You're buying his circular saw.
Here we are. Now, the blade's razor sharp, so you'll be all right.
Isn't that dangerous?
No. Not if you know what you're doing.
What if you don't know what you're doing?
You shouldn't be using it.
No, you shouldn't.
Excuse me, what have you done to your hand?
Oh, a gashit.
On that?
No, I was helping the wife wash up. Cut it on the bread knife.
Now they really are dangerous. Now I'm ready. Where do I switch it on?
Do you mind if I don't watch? Oh, excuse me.
I'll just plug it in.
Ah! June, have you got a needle?
Oh, no. What's got to be sewn back on?
Nothing. I've got a splinter in my hand.
All right, Uncle. What do you want to get rid of?
No, as far as I'm concerned, everything I need is this end for a workshop.
Oh, just a minute. Before you start getting rid of things, there might be something out here I want.
Well, if there was something out here you wanted, it wouldn't be out here, would it?
Well, I don't know till I've looked.
All right, well, go through everything one by one. If there's anything you need, just shout.
Right.
Now, you don't need this whole roll of torn lino, do you?
No.
Fine. You don't want that broken table, do you?
No.
You don't want that bed with a busted spring, do you?
Oh, no.
Well, there's a start, Alan. We don't need the lino, the bed, or the table.
Don't blame you. I don't want them either.
What do you mean you don't want them?
Well, what am I supposed to do with them?
Do with them? Well, sell them.
Who to?
Well, I don't know. I mean, you're the furniture salesman, for heaven's sake. I mean, you're the one that's got vans speeding all over Europe full of furniture.
The only place I'd be speeding to with that lot's the rubbish tip.
You mean there isn't anything out here you want?
Well, I could do you a favour and take this old wardrobe, this chest of drawers and this gong.
Oh, no, not that.
Why?
Well, we've had it ages. I'm very fond of it.
Well, what's it doing stuck out here, then?
Well, I can't think where else it can go.
How about Hamburg?
Oh, no.
June, I need the space.
I wouldn't mind if I knew it was going to a good home.
Oh, what happens if it goes to a bad home? What do they do? Ill-treat it, not feed it properly, or what?
You know what I mean? I'd rather it went to someone we know.
Well, it's going to Alan. We know him.
Yes, but he's going to sell it in Hamburg.
Frankfurt.
Well, I'd rather it didn't go abroad.
They'll look after it, Auntie. They're ever so good to gongs in Germany.
I mean, they're well known for it. I mean, they overdo it, they spoil it. In any case, it hasn't had such a good home here, has it? It's been stuck out in the garage for years.
Oh, well, I don't know. Perhaps I am being silly.
Shall I take it, then?
Yes, all right.
And while you're at it, you can take that chair as well.
Won't get much for that.
We're not asking much for it.
You mean you want me to pay you for taking it?
I thought you were buying and selling furniture.
Yeah, but your family are... I thought you were giving it to me.
Oh, you're not buying and selling, you're scrounging and selling.
Well, Alan, you're certainly not having my gong.
You're not having any of it.
All right. You can't blame me for haggling a bit.
Oh, I like your idea of haggling.
All right, Uncle. What do you want for the lot?
30 quid.
10.
20.
15.
Done.
I'll pick it up on Tuesday night.
And Mackie, what about the 15 quid?
Oh, you'll have to wait until I come back.
When you come back for the furniture?
No, when I come back from Frankfurt. See you.
Rank insolence. Oh, June, you're just in time. I'm about to do some turning. You can watch.
No, I'm afraid I can't. I promised Tarquin and Melinda that I'd help them deliver some newsletters.
Well, don't you deliver one here. I shall tear it up. And by the way, this saw isn't working. The driving belt's broken.
Is it?
Yes, almost as if somebody came out here and deliberately cut it with a knife.
Oh, no.
Now, June, if you'll do Primrose Avenue, Melinda's doing Candy Drive. There's that drummer again.
He started early.
Splendid. Now's our chance to find out who it is. Come on, follow me.
Here we go!
What on earth's that?
Sounds like machinery.
It's coming from that way, back where we live.
Oh, yes. Why don't we find the drums first?
What's that?
Find the drums first.
Yeah, we've got to wreck it.
If you're delivering new sheets, I don't want one.
We represent... we represent the Noise Abatement Committee.
I'm sorry, I can't join. I'm too busy.
Stuff.
Your silencer's gone.
Yes, I know. But
why don't you turn off the engine?
Because if I turn it off, I can't start it again.
I'm sorry, old boy. I can't hear a word you're saying.
Oh, heck.
What's all that stuff doing out there?
Alan's van broke down. They had to unload it before they could tow it away.
Oh, I see. Oh. Oh,
those
dear.
Wretched kids. Every time they go by, they bang it.
Well, don't leave it out there. Bring it in.
Oh, it's not that so much as the piano. They can't leave that alone.
Sorry, officer, I thought it was the kids playing it.
Is this your piano, sir?
Why? Why are you asking?
It needs tuning.
I forgot to tell you. Tarquin found out who the midnight drummer was.
Good.
And I think the Noise Abatement Society are going to ask you to be their vice president.
Ooh, too late now. My interests lie elsewhere.
Yes, that's what's worrying them. Oh, listen to that.
Yeah, he's playing very well, isn't he?
Look at the time. It's nearly 1 o'clock. Oh, go on, call out to him.
Oh, all right. You know what'll happen, don't you?
What?
I'll shout, do you know it's 1 o'clock in the morning? And he'll shout back, no, but you hum it and I'll play it.
Just tell him to shut up and clear off.
Well, it's rather rude, isn't it?
Well, if you won't tell him, I will.
Oh, good idea, love. Only don't shout too loud. After all, you're on the committee of the Noise Abatement Society. Can you see him?
No, it's pitch black.
Good Lord, he must be playing by ear.
Excuse me. I say, excuse me, would you mind awfully not playing the piano? Would you please shut up and clear off?
Well, that shifted him.
I don't think he could have heard me. You'll have to go down and talk to him.
Do you mind if I wait till the end of this tune? It's one of my favourites.
That'll be the neighbours again. We've already had 2 complaints about the piano.
Hello? Yes. Yeah. Certainly, yeah.
Another complaint?
No, a request.
A request?
But I tell you what, I'm not going to attempt it, certainly not with a piano.
Are you going downstairs to talk to him or shall I?
All right, I'm going.
Sounds as if he's drunk.
Well, he's playing very well.
Look, if he turns nasty, don't antagonise him. I don't want you to get hurt. My husband's coming down to talk to you. Are you all right? Oh. What's he done to you?
Nothing. I stubbed my toe on something.
Who was it playing?
No idea.
But didn't you speak to him?
No.
You mean when he saw you, he ran off?
No.
Well, what happened?
Well, it wasn't our piano.
What?
No, it was Tarquin next door.
Tarquin?
Yeah, he got the radio turned full up and the window open, and that's marvellous, isn't it? He's president of the Noise Abatement Society.
I'm so worried. I thought something awful had happened to you.
No, I'm all right, love.
Oh, I nearly phoned the police.
I shouldn't bother. They're here.